Okay, so here's the way this is going to work tonight. The camera is focused on this area right here from where I'm standing to about right here. So when you get your presentation, when you get your awards, the presenter will meet you here to make your presentation. So we'll have it on the camera, we'll have it on film, I'll have it up on YouTube probably by the end of the week or first part of next week. So please look for that. We did this with the youth a week ago Sunday in this facility, and it worked out really well. So we'll do that for all of you tonight. So if you get your presentation, you'll get your moment in the sun. Okay, President John Borpagel and George Brzezinski for presentation to the women's champions. The Division I team this year, the team chosen with a score of handicap score of 36-92, Wanda Jones, captain, Carol Brown, Vanessa Horton, Nicole Lamar, and Julia Woodall. Please stay, come on up. Get to work. Pictures of any of the award winners, come on up. We'll have you stand to the left over there, take the pictures. Probably not as much in this crowd as we had with the kids, but you never know. Division II team in the women's championships, the Tuesday Topplers, number 3, with a score, handicap score of 36-41, Ruth Bradburn, Margaret Grace Eggleston, Carol Hare, Mary King, and Sandra Meredith. Actual division, Tees Peeps with a 32-46, Tanisha Burris captain, Lisa Bishop, Julie Halstead, Michelle Kearns, and Cindy Patterson. Doubles Division I with a handicap score of 16-16, Danielle Bradley and Felicia Boyer. Carla Harrington and Wendy Judenin. Congratulations. In the actual doubles, with a score of 14-76, Sonia Butler and Nicole Wilson. In singles in Division One, with a handicap score of 8-62, Christy Rosso. George, maybe it's you. You know, the ladies come up here, you give them their jacket and they're gone. Division Two, she's already got her award, but let's recognize her once again with an 8-32, Felicia Boyer. In the actual, in singles, Brandi Remy with a 7-83. All events in Division One in the handicap, Joanna Torres with a 23-39. And in the actual, she's already received her award, Brandi Remy, 21-89. Okay, in Division II handicap, with a handicap score of 23-60, Barbara Brisson. Maybe it's not just George. Division II actual, she's already received her award for this also with a 17-24, Felicia Boyer. In the senior all events handicap, again she's received her award, you saw her just a moment ago, Barbara Brisson, 23-60. Okay, now turn the page. We're in the Open Championship. As you recall, the Open Championship and the Women's Championship run together. This year, our host center was Shore Lanes. Next year, the Open and Women's Championship will be at Century Bowl in Waterford. In the actual division and the handicap division both, the Stagglers with a 35-95 scratch, 37-96 with handicap. Eric Hubener, Kyle Hubener, Mark Milosinovich Jr., Jason Nyman, and their only representative, Jay Simon. Look for the camera, Jay. Congratulations, Leslie. In the doubles in the actual division, Ryan Brulio and Ronnie Carroll, 15-06. Don't believe either one of them are here tonight. In the handicap division with a 16-02, Antonio Funches and Brandon Parker. Here tonight. Singles, actual and handicap, Derek Wright, 814, 901 with handicap. And the next guy's here. Trust me. Actual all events, John Kelly, 2261. Division, Dawn Polomsky with 2396. She's not with us tonight either. We run a senior tournament every year. As I indicated earlier, it was at Score Lanes this year. And so next year it'll be at Sterling. So in that handicap division for the senior tournament, Harbor number one with a score of 3640. Cheryl Filarski, Lawrence Huntington, Sue Hyvenen, Rochelle Mobley, and Ed Zagalski. Tournament was at Hazel Park. It will be at Hazel Park in the fall. None of these people are here, but we would like to recognize them. Chris's team with a 2900 with handicap, Yolanda Berry, Mark Brown, Aaron Hensley, and Chris Sage. In the doubles with a 1592, Kiva Saylor and Scott Woodward. We run a 500 club tournament every year. For those of you that don't know, the Metro Detroit USBC runs about 18 tournaments a year for all the members. We have tournaments for every part of the membership, whether it be a handicap or scratch competition, whether it be youth, whether it be women, whether it be adults, mixed, we do it all. And so this year our 500 club tournament was at Airway Lanes in Waterford, and the champion this year with a handicap score of 796, Andrea Walker. Congratulations, Andrea. You know, we couldn't be as successful as what we are at times without squad organizers. We have four of our squad organizers we're going to honor. Only one of them is here tonight, but we do honor them with a jacket for their efforts. Squad organizer is somebody that organizes 10 teams or more for the Open and or the Women's Championship. So at this time, I'd like to recognize Libby Fletcher. I think she was 14 teams in the city tournament this year, and 32 in the state tournament. Brings a squad the opening weekend of every year in the Women's Championship. She brings 10 teams in. Doug Williams, he usually brings in anywhere from 12 to 16 teams, some men, some women. We appreciate their support. And Chrissy Wissinger brought a squad of men to the Open. It wasn't all men, but mostly men. And a squad of women to the Women's Championship. So we appreciate all of their efforts. So let's give them all a nice round. As I indicated, we run a number of tournaments, and our five premier tournaments, scratch tournaments, we're going to make those presentations next. And John Warpagel and George Brzezinski are up here to help. Unfortunately, some of them are not here tonight, but those that are, we will definitely honor. This year, our Masters champion, we were at Thunderbolt Lanes, and he's not here with us tonight, but Justin Knowles is our Masters champion. And our senior Masters champion was Troy Stuss. Troy's not with us either, unfortunately. The next one's not here either, but he sent a couple of representatives, as he always does. The Super Senior Masters champion is Harry Sullins. He can't be with us tonight because he's out in Vegas bowling in the Senior U.S. Open, but he sent his sister and his 95-year-old mother to accept. Wave your hand, Mom. Wave your hand. There's your girl over here. Our Queens champion this year was Robin Orlikowski. Our senior Queens champion back to back. And something about, can she do it a third time?
Yes.
Terry Ketchcole. Side for the 55th year, we're going to name an all-city team, and for the women, we're probably somewhere north of 50 years for the women, about 10 years for the senior women and the senior men's all-city teams, but we'll do those at this time. So the women's all-city team, first team, Sarah Locher, Michelle Kern, Sonia Butler, Brandy Remy, and Ashley Denard. Those of you that don't know, Ashley threatened me at the end of the women's state tournament this year. Now I'm getting it again, it looks like. She threatened me at the end of the women's state tournament this year at Dareway, and she said, if I don't make the all-city team this year, you and I are going to have some talking to do. I did. But her numbers spoke for herself, because that's what it's all about. If you don't like your picture, send me a picture for the file so when you win again, I will make sure to use it. That's all I can tell you. So Ashley, if you're so proud of that picture, why are you showing it off?
I was actually showing off
Stone's first. Okay, the second team, Women's All-City. Julie Halstead, Nicole Wilson, Jennifer Maples, Jenna Law, and Lisa Lambert. And at the same time, I'd like Cassidy Halstead to come up. Cassidy is Julie's daughter. Cassidy made the all-city team for the youth this year. She was not available for the banquet a week ago Sunday, so we're presenting her medal today. Ashley and Jen, I think that picture was taken at the same time.
No, it wasn't.
Yes, they are.
When you guys won the doubles at the women's series?
Okay.
Anyway, congratulations, ladies. Like I said, if you don't like your pictures, you know my email address, send me a picture. Okay. And it better look like you, too. Once again, for the 55th time, this is the men's all-city team. Captain John Kelly. Ronnie Sparks Jr., Jay Lang, Andrew Anderson, and Kurt Pilar. Now that's a real captain. He's going to take the rest of the plaques for the rest of the team. Second team for the men's all-city. Unfortunately, none of them are in attendance tonight. Christopher Nielsen, Jeff Ostrang, Ryan Van Hecke, Ryan Brulio, and Ken Wyatt. Okay, for the senior women's all-city team, first team, Captain Sandy Schultz, Terry Ketchpole, Tori Taylor, Jean Gebbia, and Krista Winbigler. Speaking of pictures, Ashley, Jeannie wants to know where I got hers. It's a black and white picture. Congratulations. Second team, senior women's all-city team, Belinda House, Juana Torres, Pam Jones, Deborah Waxler, and Diane St. Louis. The picture to the person. Huh? Oh, I'm sorry, the pictures aren't very good. We'll take care of that. All right, senior men's all-city team. I guess before I go on, I want to step back just a little bit. Nicole Wilson, would you just stand up for a second? I'd like to recognize Nicole as the state Queens champion this year. Congratulations. Senior men's all-city team, first team, Captain Ken Wyatt, Mike Calvin, Eddie Mintz, Harry Sullins, and Larry Walker. Speaking of state champions, Mike Calvin was the state senior masters champion this year. Congratulations. And the second team, senior men's all-city, John Gormasti, Troy Stuss, Dave Tulak, Bob Mishaw, and Larry Wilson. I don't believe any of them are here tonight. How are we doing on time? Doing good? And nobody left either. Next up, I'd like to have George Brzezinski come up and make the presentation for the Metro Detroit USBC Volunteer of the Year.
She's a delegate to the Michigan State USBC Youth Convention that's coming up. She was a delegate to the Michigan State Women's Association Convention that we just had, but because of undue circumstances was not able to attend. She was also a delegate to our state convention, our national convention, the last 2 years, both 2017 and 2018. She's also serves on three different committees. She serves on our BBL committee. She serves on the tournament committee, and she serves on the which one?
Bowl for the Cure.
I knew I was missing one. So on behalf of the Metro Detroit Bowling Association, I'd like to present our Volunteer of the Year, Jessica Tyler.
She says she's got a long speech prepared.
Jordan is totally lying. I don't have a long speech prepared. For those of you who don't know me, I'm Jessica. I'm pretty sure I know almost everybody in the room. If not, I'm sure you'll see me sometime this season. I'm here to make the sport better and make it grow. I'm hoping that we're going to get more people younger. No offense to everybody else, but we got to get more people in here. Spread the word. Get the younger crowd going. They have to be involved. I hope that this year is better for everybody else, and I'm sure I'll see you in some bowling alley. Thank you.
Bring back our president, John Boerpagel, for the presentation, our secretary of the year. But before I do that, we have one other person in the crowd who was not here when we did the presentations or the introductions of the board of directors. But I'd like to introduce Deborah Dickerson. I hardly recognize you with your hair done differently. You and Ann Block, right? John Boerpagel and Barbara Hughes, you got to make a longer speech than Jessica. Okay.
Thank you, Mark. Yes, Barbara Hughes. She's been a secretary for over 35 years at this league. She kept it going through Holiday Bowl, Clover Lanes, and they're currently at Thunder Bowl. She always posts the sheets on bowl.com. And league certifications, their certifications get sent in a timely manner, and everybody appreciates that. And she's always there to help out any situations. But 35 years plus on this one league, let's give her a round of applause. So on behalf of the association, I'm happy to present her with her plaque and her new briefcase. Congratulations.
power and trying to get it going on. Yeah. And thank you, everybody. I really appreciate it.
We really have a great sport, and what's the best part of our sport?
Friendship.
Friendship. That's right. Friendship. You know, we all like to bowl well, but guess what? We don't always bowl well, right? But we always have our friends that we bowl with. And really, that's the thing to remember. As Jessica said, let's bring some more people into the sport, people that you work with, relatives of yours, even if it's just a short season league, get them involved, get them hooked young, because all of us started young. Because we know if you don't start young, it's harder to start later. So once again, thank you to all of you for being here tonight. Thank you for your consideration for all the award winners. Congratulations to all the award winners. And we'll see you next season. Thanks. Folks.
Thank you.